Daily Evening Prayer, Friday, January 5th, 2024. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom then shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom then shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host were encamped against me, yet my heart would not be afraid, and though war rose up against me, yet would I put my trust in him. One thing I have desired of the Lord, one thing I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the fair beauty of the Lord, and to seek him in his temple. For in the time of trouble he came, he shall hide me in his tabernacle. Indeed, in the secret place of his dwelling he shall hide me, and set me high upon a rock of stone. And now he shall lift up my head above my enemies round about me. Therefore I will offer in his dwelling an oblation with great gladness. I will sing and speak praises unto the Lord. Hearken to my voice, O Lord, when I cry unto you. Have mercy upon me and hear me. You speak to my heart and say, seek my face. Your face, O Lord, will I seek. Oh, hide not your face from me, nor cast your servant away in displeasure. You have been my helper. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord takes me in. Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me in the right way, because of my enemies. Deliver me not over to the will of my adversaries, for there are false witnesses who have risen up against me, and those who speak wrong. I would utterly have fainted had I not believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. O wait for the Lord, be strong, and he shall comfort your heart. O put your trust in the Lord. Unto you will I cry, O Lord, my rock. Do not be deaf to my prayer, lest if you do not answer, I become like those who go down into the pit. Hear the voice of my humble petitions when I cry unto you, when I hold up my hands toward the sanctuary of your holy temple. O cast me not away, neither destroy me with the ungodly and evildoers, who speak as friends to their neighbors, but imagine evil in their hearts. Reward them according to their deeds and according to the wickedness of their own inventions. Recompense them according to the work of their hands. Pay them what they have deserved. For they regard not in their mind the works of the Lord, nor the operation of his hands. Therefore he shall break them down and not build them up. Praise be the Lord, for he has heard the voice of my humble petitions. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart has trusted in him, and I am helped. Therefore my heart dances for joy, and in my song will I praise him. The Lord is my strength, and he is the sure defense of his anointed. O save your people and give your blessing to your inheritance. Feed them and lift them up forever. Ascribe unto the Lord, O you mighty. Ascribe unto the Lord worship and strength. Give the Lord the honor due unto his name. Worship the Lord with holy worship. It is the Lord that commands the waters. It is the glorious Lord that makes the thunder. It is the Lord that rules the sea. The voice of the Lord is mighty in its working. The voice of the Lord is a glorious voice. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees. Indeed, the Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes them also to skip like a calf, Lebanon also, and Syrian like a young ox. The voice of the Lord divides the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. Indeed, the Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the deer to bring forth young and strips the forests bare. In his temple all cry, glory. The Lord sits above the floodwaters, and the Lord remains king forever. The Lord shall give strength to his people. The Lord shall give his people the blessing of peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Jeremiah, beginning with the fourth chapter, the first verse. If you will return, Israel, declares the Lord, then you should return to me. And if you put away your detestable things from my presence and will not waver, and if you will swear, as the Lord lives, in truth, in justice, and in righteousness, then the nations will bless themselves in him, and in him they will boast. For this is what the Lord says to the men of Judah and to Jerusalem. Break up your uncultivated ground, and do not sow among thorns. Circumcise yourselves to the Lord, and remove the foreskins of your hearts, men of Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem, or else my wrath will spread like fire and burn with no one to quench it because of the evil of your deeds. Declare in Judah and proclaim in Jerusalem and say, blow the trumpet in the land, cry aloud and say, assemble and let's go into the fortified cities. Raise a flag towards Zion, take refuge, do not stand still, for I am bringing evil from the north and great destruction. A lion has gone up from his thicket, and a destroyer of nations has set out. He has gone out from his presence. He has gone out from his place to make your land a waste. Your cities will be ruins without an inhabitant. For this, put on sackcloth, mourn and wail, for the fierce anger of the Lord has not turned away from us. And it shall come about on that day, declares the Lord, that the heart of the king and the hearts of the leaders will fail, and the priests will tremble, and the prophets will be astonished. Then I said, O Lord God, surely you have utterly deceived this people and Jerusalem, saying, you will have peace, yet a sword touches the throat. At that time, it will be said to this people and to Jerusalem, a scorching wind from the bare heights to the wilderness in the direction of the daughter of my people, not to winnow and not to cleanse. A wind too strong for this will come at my command. Now I will also pronounce judgments against him. Behold, he goes up like clouds, and his chariots like the whirlwind. His horses are swifter than eagles. Woe to us, for we are ruined. Wash your heart from evil. Wash your heart from evil, Jerusalem, so that you may be saved. How long will your wicked thoughts lodge within you? For a voice declares from Dan and proclaims wickedness from Mount Ephraim. Reported to the nations, now proclaim to Jerusalem. Enemies are coming from a remote country, and they raise their voices against the cities of Judah. Like watchmen of a field, they are against her all around, because she has rebelled against me, declares the Lord. Your ways and your deeds have brought these things upon you. This is your evil. How bitter, how it has touched your heart. My soul, I am in anguish. Oh, my heart is pounding in me. I cannot keep silent, because my soul, you have heard the trumpet, the sound of the trumpet, the alarm of war. Disaster upon disaster is proclaimed, for the whole land is devastated. Suddenly my tents are devastated, and my curtains in an instant. How long must I see the flag and hear the sound of the trumpet? For my people are foolish. They do not know me. They are foolish children. They have no understanding. They are skillful in doing evil, but they do not know how to do good. I looked at the earth, and behold, it was formless and desolate, emptiness, and to the heavens, and they had no light. I looked on the mountains, and behold, they were quaking, and all the hills jolted back and forth. I looked, and behold, there was no human, and all the birds of the sky had fled. I looked, and behold, the fruitful land was a wasteland, was a wilderness, and all its cities were pulled down before the Lord, before his fierce anger. For this is what the Lord says, the whole land shall be a desolation, yet I will not execute a complete destruction. For this the earth will mourn, and the heavens above will become dark, because I have spoken, I have purposed, and I have not changed my mind, nor will I turn from it. At the sound of the horseman and archer, every city flees. They go into the thickets and climb among the rocks. Every city is abandoned, and no one lives in them. And you, desolate one, what will you do? Although you dress in scarlet, although you adorn yourself with jewelry of gold, although you enlarge your eyes with makeup, in vain you make yourself beautiful. Your lovers despise you, they take your life. For I heard a voice, cries, cry of a woman in labor, the anguish as of one giving birth to her first child, the voice of the daughter in Zion, gasping for breath, stretching out her hands, saying, ah, woe is me, for I faint before murderers. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Galatians, beginning with the fifth chapter, the first verse. It was for freedom that Christ set us free. Therefore, keep standing firm and do not be subject again to a yoke of slavery. Look, I, Paul, tell you that if you have yourselves circumcised, Christ will be of no benefit to you. And I testify again to every man who has himself circumcised that he is obligated to keep the whole law. You have been severed from Christ, you who are seeking to be justified by the law. You have fallen from grace. For we, through the Spirit, by faith, are waiting for the hope of righteousness. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor uncircumcision means anything, but faith working through faith. You were running well. Who hindered you from obeying the truth? This persuasion did not come from him who calls you. A little leaven leavens the whole lump of dough. I have confidence in you, in the Lord,
that you will adopt no other view, but the one who is disturbing you will bear the punishment, whoever he is. But as for me, brothers and sisters, if I still preach circumcision, why am I still persecuted? Then the stumbling block of the cross has been eliminated. I wish that those who are troubling you would even emasculate themselves. For you were called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not turn your freedom into an opportunity for the flesh, but serve one another through love. For the whole law is fulfilled in one commandment, in the statement, "You shall love your neighbor as yourself." But if you bite and devour one another, take care that you are not consumed by one another. But I say, walk by the Spirit, and you will not carry out the desire of the flesh. For the desire of the flesh is against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. For these are in opposition to one another, in order to keep you from doing what you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the deeds of the flesh are evident, which are sexual immorality, impurity, indecent behavior, idolatry, witchcraft, hostilities, strife, jealousy, outbursts of anger, selfish ambition, dissensions, factions, envy, drunkenness, carousing, and things like these, of which I forewarn you, just as I have forewarned you, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. Now those who belong to Christ Jesus crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let's follow the Spirit as well. Let's not become boastful, challenging one another, envying one another. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory, of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. O God, by the leading of a star, you manifested your only Son to the peoples of the earth. Lead us, who know you now by faith, to your presence, where we may see your glory face to face, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, you have poured upon us the new light of your incarnate word. Grant that this light kindled in our hearts may shine forth in our lives, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, by your death you took away the sting of death. Grant to us, your servants, so to follow in faith where you have led the way, that we may at length fall asleep peacefully in you and wake up in your likeness for your tender mercy's sake. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation, good Lord, deliver us. From all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity, good Lord, deliver us. From all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, of flesh and the devil, good Lord, deliver us. From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart, and contempt of your word and commandments, good Lord, deliver us. From lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine, good Lord, deliver us. From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared, good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory, good Lord, deliver us. In all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death and in the day of judgment, good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church, your vessel, in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known all to all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servant, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to have mercy upon all people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord,
to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant that we may attain to your heavenly kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginnings, now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. For our enemies, defend us, O Christ, graciously behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts, mercifully forgive the sins of your people. In favor, hear our prayers, O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ, graciously hear us, O Christ, graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils. We now endure, and grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.